In this video, I'm going to provide a demo of the ASR9000's integrated DDoS solution. In this solution, we're going to be working as part of the Arbor PeakFlow SP system. In the PeakFlow SP system, there are several components. One is a group of components called SP, which are the controllers. These have the function of collecting NetFlow information to build baselines about the network, in addition to managing different components of the system called things like manage object or the GUI. That's the part that's going to continue to run out of the Arbor products, either the appliances or in virtualized VMs. The other component is called TMS, or Threat Management System. That's the part that's going to run on the ASR 9000 VSM. Doing that, we're going to be taking instructions from the SP controller, then programming countermeasures into the VSM. We're then going to use BGP to redirect traffic, and then we're going to take the traffic coming into the VSM and scrub it so we can take in 40 gigabits per second and then send just the clean traffic on to the final destination. In addition, as part of this solution, I'm going to show you BGP FlowSpec used to drop traffic. BGP FlowSpec can be used for a number of things, whether it's redirection for routing or to rate limit or drop traffic. In this case, we're going to be using it to rate limit traffic, actually to zero, which is the way FlowSpec implements a drop. So now let's get started. If we take a look at our lab, we have three routers shown here. One is called Boca, that's a CRS. Another is called Inter, which is an ASR 9000 with the VSM that you see in the bottom. And another is called Spurs, and this is the one closest to the web server that's going to be getting attacked. If we take a look at the baseline setup, we have a web client off of Boca. It's sending requests to the web server, and at the beginning, before we start the attack, we're going to see that that web page loads correctly. Now, the other things that are happening at this point is that Inter is running NetFlow on its links, which is 100.0.0.0, going to the autonomous system of Boca. So this is representing a peering link. That NetFlow is being sent to the PeakFlow SP. It's actually on the wrong side of the map here. It should be over on the right side because it's in the same AS as Inter. That information from NetFlow is going to be used to first build a baseline that is relative to each manage object, meaning things that are being monitored, in this case, the web server. That's also relative to the time of day, day of the week, and things like that. So we're going to build the baseline, and later on, when we generate an attack, we're going to use that baseline to see the attack. Notice also that Inter is connected to the VSM card. It is inside the system, but the links to the VSM card are represented by a group of 10 gig links, which we're going to be putting into a bundle. So when we do our routing later, you'll see that we're going to be forwarding traffic over this link, bundle Ethernet 2.100, and it's going to be coming back on the clean side to bundle Ethernet 2.101. So now if we start, we're going to show that this web client is successfully able to open up the page. And so now we see that we're going ahead and loading it up. It's going to come up, and the page came up cleanly. In this case, you'll see that traffic is still getting routed normally. Now what we're going to do is we're going to initiate two different types of attacks. One is a TCP SYN attack. This will cause some amount of congestion on the link, but not enough for that alone to cause the problem. The reason the TCP SYN attack is going to be effective is it's going to fill the connection table of the web server. So that alone is enough to stop the web client from being able to get there successfully. The other thing we're going to do is a 60 gig NTP amplification attack. If you look at the link in the center here, that's a 100 gig link, so we're going to have lots of ability to send traffic over to Inter for it to be cleaned. Now what we do with the NTP amplification attack, this is traffic coming from UDP port 123. There was a very popular attack that's still going on, especially was very popular in 2014, called the Monlist attack. It's an amplification attack in which you can spoof a source address and get back a much larger response than you sent. You then are directing that via the spoof source address to your victim. And so what we're going to be doing is we're going to be sending both of these attacks, and then we're going to be blocking them via two different methods. So here you see that we're starting two different attack streams, and then in a second on the bottom you're going to see the amount of traffic that we're sending. So the UDP is 60 gigabits per second and 6 million packets per second, so these are large packets, and the SYN flood is 2 gigabits per second and 2 million packets per second. So now if we look at making this connection, we're going to see first that the link's congested by that 60 gig attack. And here you can see that we can no longer open the web page. If you look on the left here, you see that the page is trying to load, but the browser is telling us that it's not coming up. So now what we want to do is take advantage of the NetFlow for attack recognition. What you see here in the alert on the top left is a couple of different things. The first you see is incoming host alert to an IP address, 11200.02. It says using web server. Web server is what in the Arbor technology is a manage object. A manage object is a thing or a group of things that have the same policy for what type of traffic they should be getting, how an attack is going to be recognized against them, as well as it also may map into the ways that we want to protect them. So in this case, we just have one web server, although it could be, for example, all of your load balancers or all of your billing servers, or it could be the data center in Tokyo. So it could be any number of things. You can define them by address blocks, by communities. There's a whole number of different choices on how you can define a manage object. But in this case, we see that we have an attack going against this manage object. We see that it's flagged as TCP SYN and UDP. We also can see how long it's been going on. We also see that it was detected via fast flood. Prior to the 7.0 release, which is roughly corresponding to late 2014, which is when this demo was recorded, we have traditionally Arbor would detect things in 1 or 2 minutes. And what that would mean is that we would have a baseline for the normal amount of a certain type of traffic or the normal amount that would come from a particular host. If in 2 minutes we received a multiple of that, maybe it's 200%, maybe it's 300%, after 2 minutes we would go ahead and, or we would wait until 2 minutes to initiate the alert. What we've done now in 7.0, which is the only version that will support the solution with the SR9000, is something called fast flood detection, and this is available from Arbor on the NetFlow collector side. What we do is we say if we've already received enough bad traffic that we would have generated an alert in 2 minutes, we'll go ahead and do that right away. So in this case, we're actually getting that in a couple seconds because we're sending so much traffic. So this is what the whole GUI looks like. You can see that there are a number of widgets in addition to our network summary and our top DDoS alerts. So now let's go look in a bit more detail at the specific attack that we've recognized. We see UDP and TCP. If we let that run a little bit longer, we'd see how much of each of the attack types are there. And what we're going to do first is, just to gain a bit more information about the attack, we're going to turn on a mitigation, but we're not actually going to program any of the countermeasures. Now, the countermeasures are what we use to actually clean the traffic. The reason we're going to do this is so that we can then sample packets. We're going to direct traffic into the TMS. We're going to then use the TMS's ability to look at the traffic to gain a bit more information. Then we're going to sample some of those packets and use that to create our FlowSpec rule and then to decide the countermeasures we're going to use. So at this point, we're going to have traffic start going through the VSM, although we're not going to actually be cleaning the traffic in the VSM, so we're not going to be protecting the destination yet. Now, if we go over to the router for a minute, you're going to see that before we start this mitigation, the route to 11200.02 is a /24 learned via OSPF. Now we're going to go ahead and start this, and you're going to see a couple things. The first is that we now have a route via BGP. This is what we call the diversion route. It is going to 1337.1338. That is the address on the other end of the bundle Ethernet 2.100 that we looked at before when we're looking at the network map. So this link is a number of connections, internal 10 gigis, going from the ASR9000 to the VSM, or specifically from the network processors on the VSM to the Intel CPUs on the VSM. So now we have traffic flowing through the VSM. We can now go and look at some of this traffic in a bit more detail. Here you see the ones that are port 123 and protocol 17. That's the UDP attack. And you notice here, if we go down to the bottom, you can see that it's 123, both source and destination. We're going to use that when we create our flow spec rule. There's also a small amount of TCP SYN traffic in here, although we really can't see it yet because the majority of the traffic is this large packet monolith attack. We also noticed, if you look back there, we would have seen that most of the packets were large packet size, and we're going to use that in our FlowSpec rule as well. So now we're going to be using FlowSpec to block the NTP attack. Now note, this is not unique to the ASR 9000 implementation. This is something that you can do and send it to all of your routers supporting FlowSpec. And if you do this, what you'd be doing normally is pushing this rule out to all of your peering routers so that this traffic is blocked in your fast network processor hardware as early as possible. So here we're going ahead and putting in this rule that matches the traffic that we saw against the specific destination. We're also going to do source and destination 123, as well as a packet size range of 900 to 1500. And then we're going to set the traffic to discard. In FlowSpec terms, that means setting a traffic rate to zero. And so it's basically policing down to zero, which is the drops. If we take a look at the FlowSpec from a router standpoint, we see before initiating this action that we don't have any FlowSpec rules. Once we start it, we can take a look at this again, and you see both that we have FlowSpec rules, so this is the full information for the match. We see the action, which is dropping the traffic, and then you see that we already have traffic matching. And when we run this command again, you'll see that we have additional traffic matching. So now this traffic is no longer reaching the VSM, and it's no longer reaching the final destination. Now what we need to do is manage the TCP SYN attack. You notice that now that we've gotten rid of that traffic, we only see these TCP SYN packets, which are small packets going to port 80 with protocol 6. And here, if we take a look at the detail of the packet, we got some information before, but now by capturing these sampled packets, we can look at them in a bit more detail, and we can use that to select our countermeasures. All right, so the next step after we look at the packet is going to be to create countermeasures to clean it in TMS, as well as turn on those countermeasures. So we're going to go in here, and we're going to turn on TCP SYN authentication. The behavior of the SYN authentication countermeasure is to send back a challenge to the sender. What we're trying to do here is find invalid TCP stacks. What we'll do is we're going to send a SYN ACK back to the source. It's going to have a specific sequence number in it. If the source that sent the packet does not respond with a valid SYN ACK back to us, then we're going to be blocking this from going to the final destination. If it does reply, at least showing that it may still be an attacker, but at least it's a valid TCP stack, we're then going to reset that connection and send it on to the final destination. This is a way we're protecting against that SYN attack. So now what we're going to see is when we start this, we're going to have a number of packets dropped. So you see where in green we have TCP SYN authentication. We now have a certain amount of traffic being dropped, and we also see the per countermeasure drops happening for that particular countermeasure. So now if we go back to our web client, and we're going to reload the page. Sometimes it may take two attempts to get there just because it's resetting the TCP or going through that countermeasure, but now we see that it is loading up correctly. And that's the end of our demo.